There was heavy deployment at Kirundo Hospital, where Chadondo East Member of Parliament Robert Kyagulanyi Ssentamu and Mityana MP Francis Zake are detained. The duo was rushed to the hospital last night by police after they were blocked from travelling abroad for further treatment. Police arrested the MPs at Entebbe International Airport, where they had checked in for their flights abroad. Counter-terrorism police personnel were heavily guarding the hospital premises, and no journalist was allowed to access the facility, while members of the public were subjected to thorough security checks before they could be allowed in. Lawyers to the ailing legislators revealed that the MPs are currently admitted in the private wing of a hospital, though expressing concern that the hospital lacks necessary expertise to treat the two bedridden MPs, a reason their caretakers have denied doctors from accessing them.
They opened, they need to those files to be investigated, so they cannot allow them to leave the country until the investigations have been done and completed. We don't know when the investigations will be completed, but part of the investigations is that they are going to be subjected to medical examination by government doctors in government facilities. So they have said they disregard examinations and reports from other doctors and hospitals.
Meanwhile, the Uganda Medical Association has condemned security agencies for barring the legislators from seeking medical attention abroad. The General Secretary of Uganda Medical Association, Dr. Mukuzi Muhereza, insists that any patient has a right to seek medical attention from a foreign medical facility with or without clearance of a medical board, thus advising government to let the ailing legislators go.
Every patient has a right to seek a second, third, or any opinion. In other words, you can come to me and I tell you you have this and this. But you have a right to go ahead and look for a second opinion. And the second opinion does not necessarily have to be the same level or upper level. A second opinion is a second opinion. Wherever you go as a patient, it's me that I have chosen, and you cannot force onto me that you must choose the second opinion from here or there.
In scenarios where the law comes in, we don't fight with the law. We allow the law to take its course. But when it comes to the life of a patient, our stand is clear that the life of a patient is our priority.
These further advised government not to subject the ailing MPs to any treatment against their will, as it is against the law. I am Rachel Nachuala for Urban TV.